Welcome back, dear participants. So, in the last video, we have covered short answer, paragraph, and multiple choice questions. So, now coming on to check boxes, for that, I have to click on plus to add another question. And now, this time, I want to ask my faculty members regarding their educational qualification. So here what I want my faculty members to do is, if they have done graduation, they have to tick it. If they have done PG, they have to tick PG also. If they have done MPhil, they have to tick MPhil also, and so on. So I want them to tick each and every option which is suitable for them. So for that, I cannot go for multiple choice. So with this, I'm referring to check boxes. Now, first option I am giving it as graduation. Another option is post graduation. Then I have MPhil. Then PhD. And we can also add UGC, NET or JR. So now here I want my faculty members to tick the qualification which is applicable for them. That is why I have chosen check boxes. Now again, I am making it as a required question. If I want to see it in the preview, see how it will look like. As you can see, in multiple choice, I was having a round circle option where I can click only on one option. In educational qualification, I am having check boxes, which is represented by square boxes. See, if I want to click on all of them, I can click easily on all the options. So this is a usage of check boxes. So for now, I am closing it. Now coming on to the next question, which is file upload, drop down. So for that, again I have to click on plus for adding a question. Now this time I want to ask my faculty members, do you want to attend this FDP? Any question for yes or no. So like, if I'm giving them an option of yes or no. So now I am choosing here drop down. So what drop down basically do is, it does not show you the options which is available with the respondent. Simply you have to click on the drop down menu and there only you will find your answers. So again, I am making it a required question, as and if you see it in preview option, see, this is how a drop down menu question will look like. Do you want to attend this FDP? When I'll click on this drop down arrow, so options will be seen here, yes or no. Now again, coming on to the next option, which is file upload. For that, again I'm adding one question by clicking on plus sign. So I am choosing file upload, continue. So I am asking here to upload the screenshot of the payment, if they have done any payment for the FDP or for any seminar and so on. So right here I'll write, please upload the screenshot of the payment. So if I do not want to specify the type of the files, I'll just keep it on close. If I'll open it, as you can see, there are many file types available here. If I want my respondents to upload only PDF, then I'll just simply click on PDF. And they will be able to upload only PDF document, and for presentation, drawing, image, audio, they will not be able to upload it. So for now, I do not want to specify the file type, so I'm closing it. So how many files you want your respondents to upload? If it is 1, 5 or 10, you can choose according to your need. And maximum file size, you can choose it as per your requirement. It can be 100 MB, it can be 1 GB or 10 GB and so on. So again, making it a required question. See, in preview option, if you will see, it will look like this. You just have to click on add file and after that, it will ask you whether you want to upload from your device or whether it has been there in your drive. So it will directly upload it from your drive. Now coming on to the another question, which is linear scale. So for that, we are adding one question. And this time I want to give a linear scale question, so I am adding it here. So linear scale option can be used whenever you want to rate something on a scale of 1 to 5. See, either you can choose 1 to 7 or you can choose 1 to 8 as per your requirement. If a question which I want to give here is, please rate the today's speaker. So for 1, if I want 1 to be the represented by very poor, I'll simply write with 1 very poor, and for 5 excellent. Make it a required question, and in preview option, if you'll see. So very poor is represented by 1, and the moment you move from 1 to 5, it become your excellent. So you can choose any one of the options here. Now coming on to the next question, for that I am adding plus, and this time after linear scale we are having multiple choice grid. So multiple choice grid question is useful when you want to rate some parameters on a scale of 1 to 5, and instead of giving each and every question separately, you give all the points in one question and the users or the respondents have to rate them from 1 to 5. Now in this, if I give a question like rate the following parameters, 1 is for below average and 5 is for excellent. If you want to give detail for 2, like 2 is for average, 3 is for good, 4 is for very good, you can also give it here. Like first parameter which I want to give is topic covered by the resource person. Another parameter which is study material shared by the resource person. Another parameter content delivered by the resource person. Then examples quoted by the resource person. And another parameter is topic was fully covered and clarified fully by the resource person. So as it is, you can add as many parameters as you want. If I want to rate them on a scale of 1 to 5, so I'll give the rating here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. You can add another parameters also, but if you want to rate them from 1 to 5, you will add just number 5 here. And after that, I am making it a required question and just going into the preview option. See, This is how a multiple choice grid question will appear. So the topic covered by the resource person, I can rate it as 5 or 4 or 3. Study material shared by the resource person. So you can click only on one option, either from the 1 to 5. So this is how a multiple choice grid question can be helpful, where you are not supposed to give separate question for separate parameters. So for now, I am closing it. Now coming on to the another question, adding a new question. And this time we are going to check box grid. So again, as I have told you earlier also, for checkbox, checkbox gives us an opportunity to click on more than one option. So again, it is an extension of multiple choice grid, where we can click only on one option. In checkbox grid, a multiple questions will be there in one questions, and we can click on more than one options, like number of sessions attended. Like day one, there is an FDP which goes on for 4 days. So, and there are 3 sessions scheduled on each day. So I want to collect information from the respondents, how many sessions in each day they have attended. So day one, day two, day three, day four, and day five. So this is session one, session two, session three. As there are only 3 sessions, so I'll write only 3 sessions here. Now making it a required question, coming on to the preview site. See, this is how a checkbox grid will appear on day one. If the respondent has attended all the sessions, he will be able to click on all the boxes. Similarly for day two, and so on till day five. So this is how the multiple choice and checkbox grid can help you in simplifying your questionnaire, where multiple parameters can be added in a single question. So for now, closing it. Now adding another question, and this time we are choosing date. So if I want to ask my respondents regarding the date of payment, when they have made the payment for this FDP or webinar or short term training program or anything else. So simply I'll write date of payment, making it a required question. Going on to the preview section and see, this is how this question will appear. They can simply write the date here, like 22nd February 2021. So on whatever date they have made the payment, they can simply write it here. And the last option under this is time. So for that, we are adding another question, and this time I am going to choose time here. And see, time of making the payment, or if you want your faculty members to tell you the time of the class which they have taken, so you can write it here also. So class timing, making it a required question. Going on to the preview section and see, this is how you can change. If I am writing I have taken the class is at 11:15, and accordingly you can choose AM and PM also. So this is how we can use all these options as per our need, as per our requirement, to beautify our questions, to beautify our way of collecting the information from respondents. So this is all for this video. In the next video, we will be seeing all these options. Thank you so much for your patience listening.